is your car fit to be on the road? Yes, you. That's food for thought. And of course, you have a huge part to play in ensuring that accidents are halted in this country. Let's now go to Bungoma Forest, where at least 500 veterans are facing eviction and have been given 7 days ultimatum on a piece of land that they occupied. According to the RDC, Chikube Amlan Tumusime, Tulipona veterans invaded the part of the forest that was given to Hoima Sugar by Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom on a 99-year lease to grow sugar cane.
Tumusime says that the district security committee has visited the location and also consulted the kingdom to find out whether these Tulipona veterans were given land to settle on.
So it's unfortunate that such a people still exist, and I have given them 7 days. Not me as a person, but the district security committee. We sat and gave them 7 days to leave. Because what is there, they don't even have toilets. I even don't know where they go to eat themselves. There are no toilets, no houses, apart from these few structures they have constructed in a period of a month or 1.5 months. But they are saying that is their land. They have been there for 20 years. No school, no any health center, no any garden. I asked them, what did you eat for 20 years? What have you been eating for 20 years? Where have you been sleeping? In trees? Because what I was seeing there, trees.
Tumusime says that it has been discovered that these people were only ferried from neighboring districts and even others as far as Burundi to come and occupy the land.
During our interrogation with them, many of them said they were picked from Kagadi. Others said they were picked from Mitiana. Others said they were picked from Obende. Others from Seruka. Others from the refugee camp in Changwali. Others said they came from Rwanda. Well, even others said they came from Burundi. Now, all of these ones were brought by one person who says is the coordinator of Tulipona, called Gideon. I have since also called him for meeting because we don't want to create unnecessary tension for nothing. You cannot just come and grab investors' land with that impunity. I'm one person who does not support evictions, illegal evictions. As another DC, I don't support that. But at the same time, I cannot allow a group of people to mobilize themselves with an intention of grabbing, knowing, let us go and grab.
Benon Tusingwire and Paul Mulindwa from the civil society blame all the mess on Bugoma's failure by the government to open up boundaries.
So actually, because we have failed, NFA and the government and NEMA have failed to impress government to come and open the boundaries. Now everybody is doing its own thing. Communities also, I believe, are entering their side. The Muhindi must even, we don't know whether there's a crossing beyond nine miles. The whole thing is a fiasco. Bugomo is going.
We are calling upon NEMA, which issued the certificate of approval, the NEMA certificate of approval to this project, to come up and regulate Hoima Sugar in its works and ensure that the conditionalities are respected, and ensure that areas which were not supposed to be cleared are not being cleared, and ensure that all other conditionalities within that approval are respected, and Hoima Sugar is not acting with impunity, acting without, you know, being regulated.
Paul Enambi, the Chikube District Natural Resources Officer, says cutting trees has continued.
This of money is not easy. What is taking place is like when it comes to charcoal burning. These people who are burning charcoal are poor people. I don't think they are cutting discriminatively. They have to cut indiscriminatively, massively. All has to go for charcoal conversion. I don't think fragile ecosystems are being protected. Now, who can take care of it? I think the issue is about money. Even when you are given a chance, you are the one. I don't think you will conserve. You'll just clear whatever you see, unless there is a technical guidance.
Bugoma controversy began in 2016 when the Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom leased 22 square miles of the forest to Hoima Sugar for cane cultivation. Since the National Environment Management Authority issued a certificate of approval, no environmental audit has been done in Bugoma. Story by Ismail Kasoha for the news in Chikube.